Hello, hello to the most wonderful community, greeting you with love and enthusiasm today. Just total excitement for today's topic. I'm sure you can hear it in my voice. We are going to be talking about berberine. Now, before we begin, I do want to tell you about the actual school of doza. Here is why you'll love it. It's a place where I teach live classes every week. We have guest lecturers. We have opportunities for you to ask me anything you want in the School of Doza. So please sign up. Go to schoolofdoza.com/signup. Tuition starts at just $5 a month. You're going to love it. The reason we are talking about berberine today is because this has been a trending topic on social media for the past year, and I want you to truly understand it because it is nuanced. It's complex. And who it's for, how much to take, and what form to look for. And I want you to have all of this. All this information is for you. And first of all, I am a huge, huge fan of berberine. So let's get into this, what to look for, and how to help you. Class is in session. So berberine, what is it, and why are people using it? Well, berberine is a plant derivative. Rhizoma coptidis is an herb that's been frequently used in traditional formulas for thousands of years. Okay, thousands of years this plant has been used, and the extract from this plant, the main active component of Rhizoma coptidis, if I'm saying that correctly, is berberine. Berberine is now been talked about over the past couple years. It's getting a lot of attention. And the reason why berberine is so popular is because people see that it helps them with their metabolism. And when we think about metabolism, I think about blood sugar. You might call it blood glucose. You might call it energy. You might call it weight, right? As a practitioner, I have to call it many things, and I can see it in labs in many different forms. But either way that you look at it, it's how we function. And the reason why people are looking at berberine, because it's been popular for weight loss. Now, these are other people's claims, not mine. But what I'm saying is, when it comes to energy, when it comes to blood glucose, that's the way I think about metabolism. And I want you to see that berberine directly supports your overall metabolism. And the benefit of doing so means that you will have a physical healthy weight. Right? Because if you lose weight, it's because you're reducing things like inflammation. It's because you're reducing things that are dysfunctional in the body. And the reason why berberine is so popular is because berberine helps support your body at reversing a lot of those issues and supporting your body functioning at an optimal level. And that's why I think I love talking about things like berberine, because it's a plant derivative, right? It comes from nature. I'm a big believer in that everything that was already given to us and that we need on earth was already here on earth before us, and it will be here after us. And so something like berberine is a plant that's been around for thousands of years, and now we're only catching up to the benefits of it because, superficially speaking, we all want to lose weight, right? That's why we want, oh, berberine, yeah, I've heard about it. Tell me more. What does it do? It's like, okay, well, this is what it does. So studies have shown that blood glucose can be a major issue when it comes to inflammation in the body. Think about the heart. Think about the liver. Think about insulin. Because if you have high blood sugar, for example, which we do typically from a poor diet, we should try to do everything we can to help support that blood sugar. Because if we can get that blood, if we can get the blood sugar under control, we can get insulin under control. And let me tell you something about insulin. Insulin is a big problem if you cannot get it under control. You will not live a very long life if you cannot regulate your insulin. And the best way to regulate your insulin is to regulate your blood sugar. And the best way to regulate blood sugar is most likely do something that restricts your calories, like a diet that is a caloric restricted diet. Adding berberine to a caloric restrictive diet has been shown, in addition with exercise, to help regulate your blood sugar and even lower insulin problems, which is quite fascinating because 1 in 3 people in this country are pre-diabetic. You could call those insulin resistant patients. I look at it as people who eat junk food every day, and I'm one of them. I mean, I had pizza yesterday. I just have a cauliflower crust nowadays, okay? I'm the same way, but my sugar intake are carbs just like everyone else. And what I found out a few months ago, basically, is the body's never going to run out of sugar. So if I'm always producing sugar and you're saying, hey, I'm addicted to sugar, because guess what? I know we always are. And that includes me. You say, okay, how do I regulate this blood sugar? Because if I'm keep eating and I have this blood sugar going into my body, what is it going to do to my body? Like, I have to store this. I have to metabolize this. I have to use this for energy. Yes, to all the above. Things like berberine helps your body metabolize all that sugar that you're eating or that you're storing or that you're releasing from your liver. And that's what's fascinating about it is that this plant-based derivative, right, this plant-based medicine, right, which is incredible. You think about it, you say, what is plant medicine? It's like, well, it's just coming from the earth. It's an extract. We do something with it and we take it as a tea. We take it as a supplement, mash it into a powder. And then all of a sudden you feel better later because it's not the medicine itself that's helping you. It's allowing the body to do its thing. Berberine goes and stimulates things in the body that allows you to metabolize the blood sugar better. It's not the magic pill in any sense. What I'm telling you is it allows your body to be able to handle all the stress that you're putting on it. That's what we do when we eat. That's what we do when we sit and we eat. That's what we do when we sit all day and stress eat. And then we go home at night and stress eat some more. All that blood sugar goes into our body in the form of carbs, in the forms of sugar, in the forms of trans fat, in the forms of high fructose corn syrup, in the forms of aspartame, monosodium glutamate, growth hormones, growth antibiotics, you know, that are promoting, you know what I mean. They're going into your chickens, they're going into your beef, they're going into the things and disrupting your body and spiking your blood sugar. And the problem with all of this to begin with is that I will take all hands on deck to help promote something that combats or helps fight off the idea that you're putting way too much stress on your body. So then I say, what's the number one thing that I'm going to help you with? Well, first of all, it's help regulate your blood sugar better. You can talk about addiction real quick because that's what we'll talk about. But what's incredible about addiction is you're not addicted to the blood sugar. You're not addicted to the chocolate. You're not addicted to that because your body will make it on its own. Okay, like this is what's really, really incredible about this. Sugar addiction is you not being addicted to sugar. It's you being addicted to the feeling you get from eating all that sugar. I was talking to someone the other day and they say they can't stop eating once they eat sugar. They just keep going. And I tell them it's because you like the dopamine hit that you get from the first bite of sugar. But then after the 50th bite, the whole pint of ice cream, there's not enough dopamine at the bottom of that ice cream, you know, cup to basically help fill your soul, because that first hit is all you need. And that's what I'm saying. You can't restrict the things that you love. It's not addiction. I mean, come on, let's be real. You're not addicted to dopamine because you need it. Okay? And blood sugar, your body will make more of it. You'll never run out of blood sugar. So tell me again why you're truly, truly hungry. It's more of a craving, right? And we know this. The craving's coming from up here in the head. So things like berberine essentially say, hey, guess what? Maybe you don't need more blood sugar. That's essentially what berberine starts off by doing to help you with blood sugar. It messes with all the hormones and the things that are causing you to think that you're a little bit hungrier. And what's incredible about that is that that's fascinating, because most people have a problem with appetite. They have a problem with portion control. And we eat way too much because we were told 2,000 calories a day. We were told 3, 4, 5 meals a day. We were told breakfast, all you can eat breakfast buffet. Sign me up with a coffee that looks like a milkshake. Sign me up before 9 a.m. Sign me up. And I'm saying, oh my gosh, you mean to tell me that nature gave us the ability to help kind of regulate this if we give our bodies a chance? I mean, now I'm saying if you eat all you eat buffet 3 times a week, you're going to have to take a lot of berberine and walk a lot of miles around your block, but that's what you're going to have to do in order to get this under control. Because like I said, 1 in 3 people in this country are obese, pre-diabetic, insulin resistant, have a fatty liver, have heart disease, sleep poorly, or on their way to some type of inflammatory issue down the road. And I'm a family practitioner screaming at the top of his lungs saying, hey, all hands on deck, because we're not getting help from our restaurants. They're trying their hardest, but the true restaurants out there, the mom and pops, the ones that are trying to make a difference, it's hard to not put sugar in your food. Sugar is the main issue in all of this. The whole reason people found out about berberine is because it helps them with weight loss. The whole reason people gain weight is because of sugar, right? The whole reason people have problems with their insulin is because of sugar. And if you have problems with your insulin, you're going to gain weight initially, but then eventually you're going to have heart disease, and then eventually you're going to have liver disease, and then eventually you're going to take out your gallbladder. You'll have gut issues this entire time. And if you outlive all of this, you could eventually have things like cognitive decline and dementia. Not to mention, most likely, cancer through all of this. Sugar is the main issue in all the issues that I see in my clinic today. And what's fascinating is I have to tell people, yes, berberine will help you, but here's the other thing. We got to get your diet under control. Because if you truly are addicted to sugar, we have to talk about this. And we have to do something here to change your approach towards food. And if you need that change, if you want to go into it even more, we have a podcast called Exploring Deeper Emotional Connections to Food. And you should go listen to it. It's really, really great. But getting back to the berberine. So the berberine is fascinating. One way that berberine can help you is it helps you with your gut. Now, everything that I've ever done in the clinic has been through the eyes of a family practitioner. One that's first line preventative approach, right? So what's the most common things that I was trained for in school? It was heart disease. It was diabetes. Obesity became a big issue, right? Because obesity is a huge issue. It's even an issue amongst kids now. And so there's also, if you're in family practice, they teach you a little bit about depression. They teach you a little about hormones. You know, you get to see a little bit of everything. But gut health is rarely talked about. Like there's no medications for the gut other than like antacids. You know, like I don't know how great those are. But, you know, like I know you say, well, I need them. And I say, well, why do you have heartburn? Why do you have acid reflux? And usually it's lifestyle induced. Gut issues start with lifestyle because your gut is essentially your digestive tract. And we have, I don't know, 4 or 5 podcasts on gut health. So please pick your episode you want to start with. I would start with healthy poops, honestly, and go to goodpoops.org if you're looking for supplements because you have gut issues. You start with our gut powder. Shout out to MSW Nutrition and our gut powder, which I take every day. It's L-glutamine, right? So like L-glutamine, berberine, it helps support your gut. And this is quite frankly saying you also have to change your diet. But what berberine does is berberine helps restore your gut microbiome. That thing that's sitting on top of your gut lining. And your digestive tract, once again, your digestive tract is a security wall. It's basically a tunnel throughout your entire body from your mouth into your anus. And it's a one-way track. Food goes in, food goes out, right? And whatever is left of it. Because you pull the nutrients from food, you break it down, you absorb what you need, and then you flush out toxins. Or you detox toxins from your body. They should be coming out in the form of pee and poop and sweat and breath. Now, if your digestive tract is blocked in any way, you're not able to detox properly. But if things get into your body that don't belong there, your body can become inflamed because it's holding on to things that don't belong in your body, like some of the things that I mentioned before. High fructose corn syrup, there's, you know, oh my gosh, if I went through the list right now, just look at the back of your nutritional label. Hydrogenated corn oil, soybean, cottonseed, like everything that's on there. Once it gets into the body, your body doesn't know what any of that is, first of all. Like your body wasn't designed for aspartame. It was designed for sugar. Like it knows what to do with sugar, but sugar from like a mango, right? Sugar from an avocado. Avocado has sugar in it, but it's healthy starch sugar. And so that sugar is what the gut actually needs, like the gut microbiome. You need to eat like plantains and avocados and cacao and apples. Like that's gut food. Like that's prebiotic foods. And when you go and you eat that and you take things like berberine along with that diet helps restore your gut. And if you start restoring your gut and you start repairing your gut, you start reducing things that are getting into the body that don't belong there. What do you think that's going to do to your liver? Well, that's going to help your liver because once things get into the gut, get into the bloodstream, they get carried up into the liver and they get stored in the liver. And then your liver has to store it like a refrigerator. And think about what you put in your liver your whole life. If you've had liver issues, you've had gut issues. And if you have insulin resistance issues, you have gut issues. There's a connection. I was not taught this in school. I was not taught that diabetics all have leaky gut. But that's true. You had leaky gut way, way in advance before you were ever diagnosed with diabetes. That's incredible, because the medical community doesn't really look at leaky gut as a thing. Right? Like they kind of do now. They were forced to, because you have everyone having gut issues. I mean, everyone I know, especially women, are constipated or have diarrhea at some point. And most guys do too. They just never talk about it, or they just rub it off as being a guy. Like they just think, oh, like it's just, I'm a guy, you know, I'm supposed to go to the toilet 4 or 5 times a day. I'm like, no, not really. Is it healthy? Like, no, it's not. You know, there's a comedian that was mentioning it one time, how unhealthy it was. And I hear that from guys a lot. And I guess maybe because I'm jaded, because guys will come and talk to me about it. But gut health is a serious issue. Serious issue. And here's what's fascinating about this. If you took berberine, like let's say you're a guy and you have gut issues, you're listening to this. I say, okay, you got to change your diet. We talked about that. Go listen to the podcast. We even have a podcast with gut foods for gut foods, you know, foods to eat for the gut. But let me tell you about berberine real quick. Let me tell you about this ingredient called dihydroberberine. All right. Now, this is really cool because I'm really proud of this. This is our new supplement. And the berberine that we have here is dihydroberberine. It's a very special form of berberine, dihydroberberine. It's a very, very special form of berberine. And this dihydroberberine, let me tell you a little bit about it. Dihydroberberine is produced by the gut microbiome. And berberine by itself is not really easily absorbed by the gut. And when you have gut issues, like most people do, you're going to have problems digesting some of your supplements. Let's just be honest. There's a lot of people who take a bunch of supplements and they still don't absorb. And we know this. This is why we have a supplement company, for crying out loud, because we know this. Like we're talking to people all the time about this. So then we're like, okay, think about this. If they're having gut issues, they're taking on this berberine, which is not easily absorbed by the gut, can be converted though into dihydroberberine by the nitroreductase produced by gut microbiome. And then the dihydroberberine enters the intestinal wall, where it's oxidized to berberine in the intestinal wall tissue, finally entering the blood circulation. That's a really cool study that shows how the body basically converts berberine into dihydroberberine in the body eventually. This is just taking it straight up. Right, it's just, we know, knowing the fact that absorption's an issue, metabolizing's an issue for a lot of people, because we have issues like that to begin with, we say, like, we'll take exactly what you need, right? But let's make it work, right? That's what I'm telling the guys now, right? I'm telling the women this. Anyone's listening, let's say you start taking our berberine. It's going to start allowing your body, like I said initially, to help you be ready to be in a position to be healthier, to be optimized, to be able to function better. Your gut needs to be repaired. Anyone's listening to this podcast, your gut needs to be repaired. And if you're taking something like berberine, you're changing your diet, you're consciously eating food that is directed at repairing your gut. Like I said, the cacao, the avocado, fish oil, all of that, like all of it's beneficial. Go listen to the GLP-1 podcast that we have. Everyone loves to talk about GLP-1. And how it helps with a lot of things, but the podcast for that talks about how fatty acids and starch help produce things like GLP-1s that help your body not necessarily have to eat as much, right? Which is one of the benefits of taking something to help stimulate GLP-1 in the body, right? We'll get into that in a little bit. But see, things like berberine have been shown to help you with blood sugar. And if you help with blood sugar, then what happens is you naturally help support your gut microbiome. That's what I want you to understand, is that if sugar is the main issue, it's directly damaging your gut microbiome, which is sitting on top of your leaky gut, your digestive tract. It's like a flooring, right? The digestive tract lining, and then the microbiome is a rug, like a carpet. That rug, that carpet is damaged. That's your microbiome, and it's not supposed to be damaged. That's your communication system to the entire body. It makes hormones, it makes neurotransmitters, it makes vitamins, and apparently it makes even GLP-1s. But if it can't do all that, it needs supplements. It needs nutrients that will. Berberine apparently is one of the best things for the gut. Incredible. So you pair that with like our gut powder, and next thing you know, you change your diet. Hopefully you start getting good poops, right? And that kind of leads me into another thing that berberine helps you with, the liver. Berberine has been shown to help you with liver issues. Let me just go through it. What are liver issues? The inability to regulate and produce sugar correctly. Period. Okay? If you can't do that, you will have a numerous amount of health issues. Insulin resistance, diabetes, heart disease, dementia, cancer, autoimmune disorders, you name it. You'll be tired all the time. You'll gain weight, right? And you won't sleep well. Your skin won't look good, right? You'll lose muscle and turn more fat into bigger fat. All if you have liver issues. Berberine, like I said, is this incredible supplement. It helps, it's like nutrients that help go directly support for the liver. When you support the liver, you don't have to directly support the liver by taking supplements that go directly into liver. I've learned this backwards. I thought everything goes into liver. Well, supplements go into the gut, right? Like I said, I just talked about berberine helping the gut microbiome. Well, guess what? If you restore the microbiome in your gut, you lessen your chances of getting fatty liver. Isn't that incredible? And I was like, okay, we're going about this whole wrong. Like I'd say, okay, we got to go after fatty liver. We got to help people with all liver issues. 1 in 4 people in this country have a fatty liver. They don't even know it. Well, those same 1 in 4 people with liver issues have gut issues, right? And those same 1 in 3, 1 in 4 people have, you know, diabetes issues and heart disease issues. And one in every 65 seconds, a person in this country is diagnosed with dementia. Like it's all collectively the same thing. It's sugar. If sugar goes into your gut and damages your gut microbiome, it throws off your liver. Because after that, everything gets into your body, doesn't belong there, and it gets stored in the liver. And then there's direct liver damage because that stuff doesn't belong there. Your liver is a refrigerator. Berberine helps you metabolize and break down sugar better. Because what berberine does is it helps regulate your blood sugar better. It helps support optimal blood sugar metabolism. I keep talking about this, which means that's going in and, like, sugar goes in and out of the liver. It's like insulin is the Uber driver, and blood sugar are all the passengers of the world. And insulin is basically picking up all these passengers and dropping them off and basically at the liver. The liver is like the biggest hotel in your body. And Uber is picking up all these passengers and dropping them off at the biggest hotel in your body, the liver. Your liver, it can't handle maximum capacity. Because there's no room for anything else, especially if those, you know, passengers, those guests in the hotel liver are horrible, like they're drunks. You don't want that. So what you need is you need all hands on deck. Give me something that's going to help my liver. Because if everyone has liver issues, berberine can help you with your liver. Berberine can help you with your blood sugar. If you help your liver and your blood sugar, it helps you with inflammation. Another way that berberine can help you is with inflammation. And inflammation can be looked at in labs. I love looking at labs. Labs are great because you have real data. I look at hsCRP in like all my clients. hsCRP is high sensitivity C-reactive protein. And if you have liver issues, if you have blood sugar issues, if you have heart issues, if you have brain issues, if you have gut issues, if you have blood sugar issues, if you have autoimmune issues, if you have hormone issues, I'm looking at hsCRP. Berberine significantly downregulates CRP. This is incredible. As a practitioner, if I see you have high hsCRP and I know that it affects your entire body, you have inflammation. That's what I know, right? It's infecting the entire body. This is a liver enzyme, by the way. And I'm thinking, okay, how do I get this down? This is a liver enzyme. If I take berberine and the liver enzyme comes down, what does that mean to you? That you're feeling better? You're losing weight? Blood sugar is under control, hopefully? Your heart disease is getting better? I don't know. Right? Because if inflammation is infecting the entire body, who knows how you're being affected? But I guess it's the entire body. So I'm going to say you're like a fire that's constantly burning. What do we need to do to put the fire out? You got to change the lifestyle. You change the lifestyle, then you say, okay, then we have berberine here. This is a supplement that I'm taking, a nutrient that helps support my liver, helps blood sugar regulation, helps support inflammation with a healthy lifestyle, right? Because that's the hardest thing. Everyone's looking for a magic pill. It's not that simple. I mean, if I were to say, yes, berberine is the only thing you need to take, blah, 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 that's not the truth, right? I can't say that. The entire podcast is me been saying, you got to change your lifestyle. Here's some gut foods to try. Try caloric restricted diets. Try intermittent fasting, prolonged fasting. Eat real food. I even talked about fish oil, right? All the things that we can do to help regulate our blood sugar. And then you still got berberine. I mean, I wouldn't have a whole podcast on berberine if I wasn't all in. We wouldn't have a whole supplement on berberine if we didn't think it was great. And then on top of it, because we know people have gut issues, we have an incredible way to take berberine so it helps absorb better. When you start taking it, even if you start taking it like on your own, you can take, 200 milligrams, start off with berberine. You can go as high as 1,000 milligrams. Just keep in mind, it might mess with your appetite a little bit. That's okay. That's what we're trying to do, right? Your body won't run out of sugar, trust me. If you're utilizing your own sugar, that's what berberine helps you do. You change your diet, you exercise more, you take berberine, you fix your gut, you go to sleep on time. Then guess what? You're going to start feeling better, losing weight. Maybe your blood sugar is going to improve. Check your labs. If you're taking our berberine, ours is dihydroberberine at 200 milligrams. Basically, you can take one to two of these a day to start off with, see how you do. If you want to take a few more, know your limits. Talk to your practitioner about it, right? And if you're doing this and you're one of those people that has problems with their blood sugar and insulin already, always tell your practitioner what you're doing because they need to know. But you yourself are going to be the ones that fixes your problems. Your problems are not going to be found in a bottle. The bottle is not the solution. The pill is not the solution. You are. I believe that you have everything you need in order to be healthy. And any health issues that you may have right now, any health concerns, I think you will be the one to fix them. I want you to find a community that supports you in what you're doing. I know that it might be tough right now, and we're all going through it, but we're here for you. There are people out there who are going through exactly what you're doing. You can do this. I believe in you. If you need any help and you want to try the berberine or you want to try our gut powder, use our code NURSEDOZA at mswnutrition.com. I hope to see you all in class. Take care. Keep working on your health.